This is my friend Alma, and I thought, what better for the 4th of July than to do something really truly American, which is to focus on the immigrant story, the story of all the wonderful mix of people who come into America from all different cultures and make it, in my opinion, so great and so beautiful. So Alma has a beautiful story about how she's come to this country and how she's chasing her dreams, and it's an entrepreneur story, and I think a lot of you will relate to it. So, Alma, tell me a little bit about the cake that you brought, why you brought it, and like what it is in the Mexican culture.
Sure. So my name is Alma, and this is a tres leches cake. So a tres leches cake, there's been debates about whether or not it's a Mexican cake, but since I'm Mexican, I choose to believe it is. Although no, it's really a Latin American cake, and it's a very basic cake. All you have is a spongy base, and then it has three milks. That's why it's called tres leches. So the cake, I think it's iconic. You can find it anywhere in any menu. When you go to a Mexican restaurant, Latin American restaurant, it's really easy to make, and I would like to show you how you can decorate it nicely, and that it's really like for everyone. People like it. You can make it as sweet or not so sweet as you want. So I think it's just perfect. I think you can find it in any type of you know, get-togethers, when you have friends, your families, for birthdays. I think it's very popular and people really enjoy it. I think what makes it really nice is that it has to be really moist, because then you bite into it and then you get, you know, that deliciousness of the milks, and then with a nice cup of coffee, I think it's great. But even, you know, like other things like wine will go well, so.
Yes, and we're gonna explore that. We're definitely gonna do a wine pairing with this. I think this is the perfect complement for a July 4th barbecue or picnic, gathering, anything like that. I know people normally think about just doing American things on July 4th. I don't even know what just American things are, since so many of the things we have in America are influenced by the immigrants. But I think that this is really cool because it's something a little bit different that somebody could host at their party, and you can really celebrate, in my mind, what makes American culture so interesting, which is this flavor and this spice that we get from all different cultures. And one thing I love, love, love so much about the Mexican culture is that people come together often.
Yes, definitely. For us, I feel like food is a way to connect. Like, food in Mexican culture is very important. It's really a time for us to just share our stories with our family, get to know each other, even if it's just, you know, your mom, your dad, your siblings, but then over the weekend you will go and meet your grandma and all your extended family. So I think it's definitely great. And I do remember this cake, which my mom didn't used to make, but I got this recipe from my godmother. And I do remember every single birthday that I had, like when I was 12, and you know, like after 12, I would always ask her to make me a tres leches cake.
Oh,
so this one is very dear and near to me.
I love that. Okay. My other question is, we were talking a little bit before about your dream to become a baker, because you guys don't even know this, but even though Alma has this incredible training as a pastry chef that you did in Paris, right? But that's not even your primary job. Your primary career is in finance.
That's right.
So how do you go from Mexico to being in finance to pastry?
I think it's one of those things that just happened to me. I grew up with food. I remember my mom always telling me, like, come to the kitchen, I'll teach you. And I was like, Mom, I'm busy, I'm studying, I need to focus on my dreams and my career and all those things that when I was little I always felt that mattered so much to me, and now not so much anymore. But basically, I just had a chance to travel, and then I experienced this culture. French pastries are amazing. And I told myself, like, food is so good. And I started like learning and enjoying it more and more. And when I moved to the US, I moved here because I had a job, you know, like accounting and finance. And so what I do, it's good, and it has given me the opportunity to like travel even more. So that's why I went to Paris. And I think baking for me has been just like a place to find happiness in a way. And I really enjoy it. It's a very different feeling when someone reviews my work for whatever I do and say like, oh, this is a good report. You know, it's good. It's a proof of my technical skills. But when someone eats a cake and they say, oh my God, it's so good, it means the world to me. So I think that's just very different.
And I love that too, because it ties into your dream that you were telling me about having not just a bakery, but a bakery that does good, and how that ties into women. So tell me a little bit more about that.
For me, my dream would be having a bakery where we give that opportunity for women to express themselves, but at the same time, learn a little bit more, eventually have their own business, baking or cooking, whatever it is, but just, you know, like empower them. I think it will be great.
Awesome. I love it. Okay, now I said we're finally gonna get to the cake.
Perfect.
How do you make a tres leches cake? What is a tres leches?
It's actually get a box cake.
Amazing. I can get stuff from there. Betty Crocker. I can go out and buy that, bake it.
Yes.
And then what do I do once I bake
it? So once you bake your cake, the most important thing is take it out of the oven, and then when it's super hot still, just be careful of course, just poke it. You can use just a fork, literally. Poke, poke, poke the cake all around. And by the time you take it out from the oven, you need to have already your milks ready to go.
Okay.
The milks are simple. So you can do condensed milk because it's going to add sweetness. You'll add evaporated milk, so it's going to help actually, you know, not make it super sweet. Mm-hmm. And then you can add any type of milk. A lot of people would like to add like coconut milk or rice milk or almond milk, whatever milk you feel.
Oh, I like that. Yeah. You can get your own little flair into
exactly.
it, whatever you like.
Okay. Exactly.
Wonderful.
And if you want to add liquor, I mean, the sky's the limit. Pretty much.
You told me you added tequila to this, right?
I've done tequila. Okay. I'm a skull trying to see, you know, like through to the roots.
Very Mexican. Used,
yeah, other type of liquors.
Okay, so now we're ready to decorate our cake, and you told us about how the tres leches cake is made, mm-hmm. and you also gave us a really good cheat. I love the little tips of what we can do is like a box cake. So let's say you do that, you just go out, you buy a cake, or you've gone ahead and made this from scratch or from the box. Lots of options here. Now how do we decorate it?
Perfect. So when you think about decoration, you have to think what you really like and what you have already put in your cake.
For this cake, Alma used mascarpone cheese and toasted almonds for crunch.
So there was something you were telling me too about why you think it would be good for women to work in a bakery and like what that does for their self-esteem and things. Like, tell me more about why having like underprivileged women working in a bakery.
I think it's important. In general, you know, regardless of the type of work that you do, I feel like women like me, we have a lot of opportunities, right?
Yes, we're very lucky.
Exactly. We came to this country and then we had a different job and it was a really good opportunity. And then I started exploring what other things I could do. I feel like all of us have so many skills and or we can even develop them. But sometimes we probably don't stop and think about that. So for me, thinking that we can give this opportunity to women that might have actually been baking in their country is good.
Yes.
They came from like different countries from where we came from. So, but they have all these skills. They were mothers and then they would be, you know, baking for their family. So they're going to know their ingredients.
Yes.
And then they can bring, I think they have so much knowledge that they can bring to the table.
So I think it's figuring out a way to let more women know that these are skills that are absolutely can be valued in the world, and there's a way to make money from them, there's a way to make a career for them, there's a way to support your family from them. So yeah, I think that's a really beautiful mission that you have. Thanks so much to Alma for coming on and chatting with me. That was so much fun. And whether you are drinking Greek wine, eating Mexican cake, or gathering with friends and having just the traditional fare, happy 4th of July.